Hello, my name is Lauren, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we are doing a reaction video to Miss, I wrote it down right there, can you see? Taylor Swift. I mentioned in my previous video that I want to react to Taylor Swift's full discography in order because I am a big Swiftie. I've been a Swiftie my whole life. Well, okay, not my whole life, but like since 2006, you know? I believe the first song I ever heard from her was Our Song. Oh, immaculate, amazing, phenomenal. You know? The more you know. Okay, anyways, we are going to listen to Taylor Swift by Taylor Swift, her debut album. This came out in 2006, and there are 15 songs. We're going to listen to it in order, the first song being Tim McGraw. I believe this was also her debut single. We're starting in the yeehaws, you know, we're doing, this is Taylor Swift strictly country music. So we gotta understand that, okay? So anyways, we're just gonna get right into it, okay. Right there beside him, all summer long. Oh my gosh, this is like baby Taylor. She was like 17 when she wrote this, like these songs and this album. What was I doing when I was 17? Is a letter that you never read. That's a good. That's such a good like debut single for her, and it's so sweet. Oh my gosh. Here we go. Picture to Burn. Yo, when I was like 8, 9, I was like singing my heart out to this, like so heartbroken. And angry with a boyfriend I never had. That was fun. I miss those days. Okay. I didn't get my perfect fantasy. I realize you love yourself more than you could ever love me. Crazy facts, but you won't mind if I say. Hold on, if you're like a veteran Swiftie, do you remember the original lyrics to this? That she had to change, that was like the first controversy or whatever. If you know, you know. Oh, she's got that country little, all your best friends. Oh my God. Oh, I wonder if her re-recordings, if she's gonna like do that. Oh my gosh. Oh, She said, if you're missing me, better keep it to yourself. And that's embarrassing. Keep it to yourself, hun. Mm-mm. I don't want to hear that. Nope. Mm-mm. Okay, now we're on to Teardrops on My Guitar. The biggest win as a Taylor Swift fan was when you had a crush on a guy with a name that she had in a song. So like if you had a crush on a guy named Drew or Steven. Obviously I've heard all of these before, but you know what? It's fun to reminisce, okay. I'll bet she's beautiful. That girl he talks about. Thank you. didn't know what he was missing out on. That's all I gotta say. Okay, this is track number 4, A Place in This World. I don't think I'm as familiar with this one, because you know there are certain songs that we like skipped. Okay, now hearing it, it does sound more familiar. I mean, obviously all of these are familiar, but you know, I recognize it.
Two very boring minutes later.
This is a very long outro. Oh my gosh. Okay, there was A Place in This World. I stand by what I said. That is a very skippable song, in my opinion. Track number 5, Cold as You. Okay, storytelling. Wait, I need to find the lyrics to these. Holy moly. Ain't no use defending words that you will never say. Wow. That's a pretty powerful line that she's like defending this person, defending what this person should be and not who they are or what they would want them to be, but that they know that they're not gonna be that person for her. Like emotional. I did not know she put any profanities in her debut album. Hold on. I thoroughly enjoyed that one. Okay, now we're on to track number 6. This one is titled The Outside. I don't think I'm familiar with this one either. Like, I don't think I listened to this one that much. I'm confused by the meaning of this. I've never been on the outside. Also, not one of my favorite songs, but it kind of gives me vibes of like a background song in like a movie, you know, that you would hear like in the background of just some dialogue or something that I don't know. Let's analyze these lyrics real quick because I'm confused with the story that is happening. Nobody ever lets me in, and I can still see you. This ain't the best view on the outside looking in. I've been a lot of lonely places. I've never been on the outside. That I would give it up all. Okay, what? I'm just a little confused by this because she literally says like on the outside looking in and then like immediately after I've never been on the outside. So I'm like, what? I'm gonna go on a stretch and say maybe she wants to look at herself from an outsider's view, that she's always kind of like introspectively looking at herself. This is a stretch. And so she wants to know what it's like to see herself from like a different point of view maybe. Let's just keep listening to the song. This is is also giving me Rapunzel vibes, trapped away. I've never been on the outside. She can relate. Okay. That was track number 6, The Outside. I need to decipher this chorus because it is eating me alive. Okay, so how can I ever try to be better? Nobody ever lets me in. I can still see you. This ain't the best view on the outside looking in. I've been a lot of lonely places. I've never been on the outside. I guess what is kind of like tripping me up is the term the outside, because to me it should be the inside, right? No, I don't know. I've never been on the outside. Can someone help me with this? Now we are on to Tied Together with a Smile, track number 7. You walk around here thinking you're not pretty, but that's not true. That you cry, but you don't tell anyone. That you might not be the golden one. Hoping it will end up in his pocket. I love that song. That's a really awesome song. Okay, now we are on to track number 8, Stay Beautiful. I love this song. Oh my gosh. You whisper songs into the window with words that nobody knows. You beautiful, every little piece now, and don't you know? Ah, I just love that. I love that little thing she does. Taking my breath. Oh, wait. Oh my gosh, I got it. I love that. Hold on. Oh, I love that. A lot of these songs have long outros. Okay, after like a 30-second outro later, this is track number 9, Should Have Said No. Okay, once again, amazing song. I was singing about being cheated on as a child and I had never experienced that. Didn't know what I was talking about, but I was angry and I was singing along to this with a passion, so. Smiles, the flowers, everything is gone. Even now, just looking at you feels wrong. Say no, baby, and you might still have me. Me to believe we could ever be the same. Nope. On high note, yes! Come on! Before you go, tell me this. Was it worth it? Was she worth it? The answer is always no if it's involving cheating on especially Taylor Swift. Come on. Oh my gosh, that outro was amazing. This is track number 10 called Mary's Song in parentheses, oh my, my, my. That sounded weird, oh my, my, my. I also love this, okay. I do really love this song. This is an excellent example of Taylor Swift's storytelling. even early on. It's amazing. Love it. Looked at you like the stars that shine in the sky. The pretty lights. This is giving me so much serotonin right now. I can't explain it. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. I just forget how amazing and how sweet this song is. Oh my gosh. I can't stop smiling. Oh my gosh. Song. Oh my gosh. On to track number 11, Our Song. Turn the radio down, he says, baby, it's something wrong. I say nothing, I was just thinking. Notice all the roses and the note that you said. Our song is a slam of screen doors, sneaking out, it's tapping on your window. Listen to the radio, waiting for something. Taylor is really good at doing that and like adding little slight differences and choruses, and it just makes it so different and it just kind of changes it up a little bit, and I really like that, so just thought I'd mention that. I grab a pen and an old napkin and I wrote down our song. All right, track number 12, I'm Only Me When I'm With You. Oh, love this. This one definitely feels different from the other ones. This one feels more pop inspired, whereas the other ones are definitely like country, like Our Song, Yeehaw, 10,000%, you know? This one doesn't feel inherently country. Okay, so this is definitely less country, I feel, than the other ones at least. Also, this seems to be another one that you would just hear in the background of a movie. I don't know why, can't quite explain it. It just gives off those vibes. Okay, I still love it though, anyways. Ooh, that ending was so good. I really like that. Now we are on track number 13. This is Invisible. Taylor's basically saying in this song, she's like, you're amazing and I see all these things that are amazing about you, and she's never gonna see them, but I see them. So you should be with me, not her. Me. The typical love triangle situation thing. She don't even know you, she never gonna love you like I want. Are there harmonies in this? There are harmonies in this. How did I not pick up on that before? Wait, what? I love what she does here, because it's almost kind of like you feel like it's the outro and then she's like psych, boom, and then she comes in like real strong. We are on the final song of the album. Well, it's not the final song of the album, but I am making it the final song of the album. This is track number 14. There are technically 15 songs, but the 15th song is just Teardrops on My Guitar, pop version. I'm gonna exclude that because I'm just keeping the original Teardrops on My Guitar. This is just more like a remix, basically. So anyways, with that being said, track number 14, A Perfectly Good Heart. This one's making me a little emotional. This one is. It's just because it's bringing out feelings of, like, in my real life. Like, why would you want to break a perfectly good heart? Why would you want to leave the very first scar? Anyways, let's give a little bit of an overview. Okay, I think this is a good album considering it came out, like, over a decade ago. Came out in 2006. Taylor Swift, her debut album, it's good. It's really good. You know, she showed a lot of promise and so much potential even back then, and she's just come such a long way since then. But even some of these are just like classics. So my favorites, I love Picture to Burn, Teardrops on My Guitar is really good. Tied Together with a Smile, Should Have Said No. I actually thoroughly enjoyed Mary's song more than I remember. And then Our Song. I would say those are probably my favorites. That is it for my Taylor Swift debut album review or reaction. Even though I've listened to this album so many times, this is not obviously a first reaction. It's just kind of like a revisit, I guess. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and stay tuned because I'm going to be doing all of Taylor Swift's albums. Next will obviously be Fearless, and this, her next era is definitely Fearless and Speak Now are when I got really into kind of like the fandom or whatever. There wasn't really even a fandom back then. I just became a lot bigger of a fan of Taylor Swift. So I'm definitely more familiar with those in later albums. Stay tuned because I do have a favorite album, and that reaction, I assure you there will be tears, probably, because it is my favorite album. It has a lot of memories, and once I get to that reaction video, I will explain kind of the history that I have with that album. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below for more if you have not already. And until my next video, bye!